So you know about the dance contest? And you know why we don't have marriage proposals up here anymore? Yeah, someone fell down last year. They could not take the heat. So, but dancing has not caused any problems yet, so we can still do that. So we're gonna bring up our two dance teams. We got Kyle with his team, and me, Mike, and my team right here. And if you've been to A-Kon Cosplay, you've seen how this has evolved in the years. It's been a lot of fun, because you guys have made it a lot of fun. It's not about us, it's about you guys. So these three volunteers from the audience, and those three volunteers, are gonna compete with each other in three quick rounds. Beyonce round. Boy band round. And freestyle dance round. So are you guys ready? So the way Beyonce round's gonna work, the song's gonna start. Me and Kyle are gonna start it off. He'll go, then I'll go, then back and forth. We're gonna do like 20 seconds, go out and back, and just have some fun. You guys ready? Yeah. Justin, start the music!
Rescue you. The life romantic movies.
push up a fuse to fill. I don't know if I can do that. I can't do that, I can tell you that. All right, Kyle, let's go.
Let's do it. Here comes Mike's team, everyone!
Hit the music.
Like
did two in one night. That's a new record. So, all right, guys. So last vote. Team Kyle. Yeah. And Team Mike. God, that's too close to call. They both win. Everyone here gets some prizes. Thank you so much for coming up. Thank you guys so much for coming up. We're gonna start this thing off right. Guys, enjoy A-Kon Cosplay!
Thank you.
evening. He's been the voice of Teen Gohan and narrator on Dragon Ball Z. Ryu on Street Fighter and Wreck-It Ralph. I'm on a Bleach and Teen on Naruto. Put your hands together for Kyle and Ben!
Good evening, A-Kon! Here we are in 2015. Are we having an awesome time or what? Me too. I'm so honored and flattered to get to come back yet again to host the festivities. You guys ready to see some awesome cosplay? But before we do that, you got to have judges. Let me introduce our judges for you. Number one, cosplay director and head of Radio Comics, Ellen Winkler. Put your hands together. I can't read this word, but it says, something owner of Pirate Kitty Crafts.
Cat.
Cat? Cat is the owner, right?
Yes.
Hi, Cat. Next up is Caroline Clavel of Mind Taylor Cosplay, our co-cosplay director tonight. Come on, put your hands together. Next up, Valor Requiem, King of Bling, and cosplay guest! Lee Kovacs, aka Pikmin Link, official costume designer for Nintendo. And last but not least, Carl Martin of Sheikah Studios and Heroes of Cosplay. As I mentioned before, we have lots of lovely cosplayers for you to peruse. We've got the walk-on category and the skits. We're going to start, of course, with the walk-ons. Are you ready? Let's get the show started with entry number two. See what we did there? Number two. Number two. Hailing from Angmar, he is the leader of the Nazgul, the Witch King. Created by Preston Hawkins. Entry number five for the walk-ons. Welcoming all the way from the country of hearts, the Red Court, escorted by the Manhunter himself. It seems like Alice is part of the Red Court today. It's best not to argue, or it's off with your head! Vivaldi, the Queen of Hearts, Peter White, the White Rabbit, Blood Dupre, the Mad Hatter from Alice in the Country of Hearts, worn by the Marx and Moody's, created by Alyssa Smith Moody and Katharina Marx. Entry six, she truly is the best legend in her league, Ghost Bride Morgana from League of Legends. Number seven, introducing one of Kanto's prototype, the power-armored Slowpoke Soldier. Original characters inspired by Pokemon. Worn by J-Hood Cosplay. Created by themselves. Callisto and Calliope started working together making women's fashion, but wanted to try making cosplay together. This is their first attempt at a cosplay competition. Princess Mononoke and Lady Eboshi from Princess Mononoke. Born and created by Callisto and Calliope. Entry Sentry number 9, just released from his stone prison. He is ready to take over Equestria with his Chaos Watch. Out for his pink cotton candy clouds and rain chocolate milk, because they're coming for you! Here is Discord from My Little Pony, Friendship is Magic. Discord from My Little Pony, Friendship is Magic, worn by Kyoke Uchiha, created by himself. Entry number 10. Sarah travels to the land of the Goblin King in hopes of getting back her younger brother. She not only faces trials that challenges her mentally and physically, Sarah from Labyrinth. Or not. If you were to see Sarah, it'd be worn by Medusa's Mirror Cosplay, created by Amber Mapp. And now entry 13. These Poke Cuties aren't only good at contests, but also good at using their charm to catch your heart. Mei and Licia from Pokemon. Worn and created by Lily and Katie. From the anime Date Alive. Yoshino is a spirit who appears as a young girl, is very shy, and uses her rabbit puppet to communicate. Born by Sage and created by Holly Leakey. Hey, you guys remember Sarah from Labyrinth? She's here now. Entry number 10, Sarah from Labyrinth. Worn by Medusa's Mirror Cosplay, created by Amber Mapp. Entry number 19, a small group of cosplayers from the DFW area. Been cosplaying for multiple years, but this is our first time entering a contest. Aqua, Ventus, Benitas, and Terra from Kingdom Hearts Birth by Sleep. Worn by Potatoes of Cosplay. Created by Nipa, Andrew, Grace, and Mallory. Living in both the worlds of humans and ghouls, the legendary eye patch ghoul, Kaneki Ken from Tokyo Ghoul. Worn by Bilal Lee, created by Nipa, Andrew, Grace, and Mallory. Entry 21. Giant monsters terrorize the lands. What do you do? Run, hide, cower? No! You kill them and carve their bodies to build better weapons and armor to kill bigger monsters, of course. The monster hunters are here! Entry number 22 on our walk-on category. From the dark side of the moon, she will punish you. Negative Serenity. Negative Serenity is worn by Exclusive Geek, created by Elise Folien. Entry 23, he has the shiniest meat bicycle, Creed from Borderlands 2. Creed from Borderlands 2 is created and worn by Nine Circles Cosplay. Entry 26, she has limitless power, Syndra, the Dark Sovereign from League of Legends. Syndra is worn and created by Larissa Lagelfo. Entry 27, Yuri Lowell, who goes on a journey with a noble named Estelle to find his old friend Flynn. He eventually warns the guild Prey Vesperia as he and a group of friends start carrying missions for Estelle, which involve searching for old ancient creatures. Estelle Sidos, Herosine, and Flynn Sipo from Tales of Vesperia. Devil's a part-timer. Entry number 25. Entry number 29, the champion of Kurt Wall and Blood Mage Extraordinaire. Here's Garrett Hawk, champion of Kurt Wall from Dragon Age. Created by myself and Desiree Gonzalez. Entry 30B. On the last exciting episode of Dragon Ball Z, Broly tamed his pet cat Beerus. Here's Broly. Created by Luisa, did the heavy lifting. Fairy Tale. category. She's powered by love, Star Sapphire from DC Comics. Star Sapphire is born and created by Stella. Entry 33, patrolling the Mojave almost makes you wish for nuclear winter. I've heard these guys chew nails and spit napalm. Ranger 54 and Ranger 56 from Fallout New Vegas. Born and created by Ranger 54 and 56. All he cares about is his bounty money. Welcome to the stage, the great Jabba the Hutt. Ooh, 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 ooh. Ah, 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 Joshua McDonald and Will Brannon. Created by Joshua McDonald, Sean McDonald, and Emma McDonald. Entry 35, CL is looking for his butler. Have you seen him? Here's CL for Black Butler. CL is worn and created by Butterfly. Entry 36. I didn't go looking for adventure. It found me. Laura Croft from Tomb Raider. Laura Croft is worn by Cole Hart 4AM Cosplay, created by Carolyn Davis. Entry 37. From the Phantom Show, the girl with the power to reattach missing limbs. Machi from Hunter x Hunter. Machi is worn and created by Joanna. Entry 38, straight from the Northern Water Tribe, here is Sokka from Avatar. Born and created by John McCann. Entry 39, an unlikely pair team up tonight, Lady and Virgil from Devil May Cry 3. Lady and Virgil, portrayed by Elaine Brackett and George Byers, created by Elaine. Entry 40, don't underestimate the power of fairies. Here is Valerie from Pokemon XY. Valerie is born and created by Teffa. Entry 41. Mars power makeup, Venus power makeup, Jupiter power makeup. Here's Mars, Venus, and Jupiter from Sailor Moon Crystal. Created by Anne. Entry 42. She's one of the crystal gems, and she's here to save the day, but not before she eats some privates with Steven. Here's Amethyst from Steven Universe. Is one created by Juniper Cosplay. In our walkout category, entry number 43, she'll cause a chemical reaction in your hearts. Ladies and gentlemen, Honey Lemon from Big Hero 6. Honey Lemon is worn by Kefri, created by Kefri and Mom. Entry 44. Do not forget this devil's power. You are unworthy as my opponent. Here is Corrupt Virgil from Devil May Cry 3. Corrupt Virgil is worn by Jay Reed, created by G. Feline Designs. Entry 45, won't you come dance with us? Quack! Princess Tutu and Miss Adele. Mackenzie Marks and Katie Collins, created by both. Entry 46, don't blink, blink and you're dead. They are fast, faster than you can believe. Don't turn your back, don't look away, and don't blink. Weeping Angel from Doctor Who. Weeping Angel is worn and created by Miss Sutcliffe. Entry 47. They've collected all their materials to create their new armor. Hunters from Monster Hunter 4. Created by the same. Entry 48. Welcome to your new life. Moving to a new town means making new friends. Here's Rosie from Animal Crossing. Samantha Lopez, created by Jessica Lopez. Entry 49, Kinetic Card, here's Gambit from Marvel Comics, yo. It's worn by Magic, created by Tyler Smithart. Already way better than Channing Tatum, right? Entry number 50, are you worthy? Here's Thor. Yes, that Thor. Here for their first A-Kon, Natsu and Urza from Fairy Tail. Worn by Jaden and Samantha, created by Samantha. From the untamed northern wilderness, Snow by Night is the daughter of winter, from the webcomic of the same name. Snow by Night, worn by Grace Jacobson, created by the same. Entry 53. From the depths of Wonderland, these card guards have gone astray and are looking for their new queen. Sakazu Card Guards, Aaron and Ash, worn and created by. Entry 54. Last time on Dragon Ball Z, Broly! Broly is worn and created by Breelon.
And the Rock!
Entry 56, straight out of Gotham, the Arkham Boys. Deathstroke, Ra's al Ghul, and Batman from the Arkham game series. Worn by Esteban, Anthony, and Vincent, created by Sean Zheng. And entry 57, according to my notes, the final walk-on. In his burning quest to capture Lupin, Zenigata finds himself an A-Kon. Zenigata from Lupin the Third. Born and created by Edward. Thought that was all the walk-ons, but no, there's walk-on advanced. Entry number one for walk-on advanced. It's not every day you find out your mother's some kind of crazy feral vigilante dragon lady. Balthazar from How to Train Your Dragon 2! Is born and created by Shinoga. Entry 3 in our walk-on advanced division. Hailing from Jiha Village and the vast surface overrun with beastmen, they fight to overthrow the injustice done to all spiral kind. Welcome Jams Cosplay as Super Galaxy Simon and Anti-Spiral Nia from Tekken Toga Gurren Lagann. Jams Cosplay and created by Jillian.
You don't want your Mac?
Entry number 4. Once hailed as Akatosh's greatest creation, his fight with the Dovahkiin changed him. A strange shout that was sure to bring his downfall turned him into the very creatures he hated. A mortal female! Now, a dragon only in soul and temper, he is still all-powerful. His might tore the dragonborn asunder even in this form. And now he will reign all over all in existence. Say his name only in fear of his power, for you will all soon be servants at his feet. Bane of kings, eater of worlds, Alduin from Skyrim. Alduin is worn by Nyx, created by Coat of Arms Cosplay. Entry 5. Let nothing escape the senses of the detective from Milky Homes, Cornelia Glauca, from the Tantai opera Milky Homes. Worn by Lika's Dollhouse Cosplay Studio, created by Weishi Tsai. Entry number 6 in our advanced walk-on. I'm late for a very important date. White Rabbit Miku Hatsune from Vocaloid. Born by Mitsu Bunny Cosplay, created by Mitsu. Entry number 7, Rapture, a city where the artist would not fear the censor, where the scientist would not be bound by petty morality, where the great would not be constrained by the small, and with the sweat of your brow, Rapture can become your city as well. Big Sister from Bioshock 2. By Havoc Lily. Entry 8. Our next contestant is one of Fairy Tail's strongest wizards, Urza Scarlet in her sapphire guardian armor. Her passions include criticizing bad behavior of other guild members and cheesecake. Her hope for the future is to instill fear into the hearts of all who oppose peace and justice. Urza Scarlet from Fairy Tail, born by Lydia Delgado, and created by the same. Entry 14. In the world of Ibelis, the terrorist cult Mullenkamp has seized control of the ancient city of Liamond. Three factions now vie over the sacred grounds. Please welcome Lady Nisa, Kalo Merlos, and the self-styled prophet of the apocalypse, Sydney Losterot, from Vagrant Story. By Atelier Heidi and Azure Ross. Entry 15 in our advanced walk-ons. Introducing the Pillar of Sephiroth, Sarah Espergen as Princess Emerald, and the Magic Knight of Fire, Hikaru Shidu from Magic Knight Rayart. Espergen Cosplay and Velvet Rose Cosplay, created by Sarah Espergen and Danny. Entry 16. This is Lowly Poison's 13th cosplaying and attending A-Kon. She creates her cosplays with character accuracy and solid construction in mind. Body paint provided by Cosplay Cosmetics. Lady Death from Chaos Dynamite Comics. Lady Death is born and created by Lily Poison. Entry 17.
Batman's worst Batman nightmare.
Oh, botanical nightmare. If he was a medieval knight. Alchemist Poison Ivy. A medieval marvel of natural potion power. Completely handmade leather armor with resin crystals. Work of mines, LEDs, leather flowers and leaves, hand-sewn wig and handcrafted jacket. Walk slowly because you're in her jungle now. Alchemist DC's Poison Ivy, worn and created by Eva Birch. Entry 18. This is Mermaid Princess cosplay as Alice Liddell from American McKee's Alice. Madness returns in her siren outfits. Alice Liddell, worn by Mermaid Princess Cosplay, created by Eva Birch. Entry 19. Fortunately for you all, Ryuko is unable to perform her decapitation move today. Ryuko Matoi from Kill la Kill. Worn and created by Ashes Array. Entry 20. More likely to be found in a Victorian ball than a Pokeball. Natural form Victorion. For Pokemon, historically accurate. Entry 21. When she's up in the club, you're not gonna reach her telephone. Telephone from Sakizu. Born and created by Jennifer White. Entry 22. In our advanced walk-on. Why be a princess when you can be a queen? Introducing Queen Beryl and Princess Serenity from Sailor Moon Crystal. Born and created by Luce Lois and Chibi Axel. Entry 23 from the Six God Generals, Ash from the Bloody from Tales of the Abyss. Ash the Bloody is born and created by John. Entry 24, Ryu from Street Fighter, Hadouken! Jorugen! That's a monkey's emotion! Born and created by Patrick. Entry 25, tough as a dump truck and nearly as big, three Goliaths are the worst things on two legs since Tyrannosaurus Rex. The Baron of Hell from Doom. Born and created by Baron of Hell. Entry 26. I've told you and told you, Richard. Doom will always be superior. Here's Dr. Doom. Poor Reed. Born and created by Tyler. System falls under the iron grip of Andros, one team will be called to duty to take him down. Team Starfox, making its debut for the Lilac System. However, Andros has hired his own team of mercenaries to take them out. Team Starwolf, wreaking havoc on all that shall oppose.
You'll always see me getting out of control. 10 minutes.
Caruso from Star Fox. Formed by Star Fox and Star Wolf. Created by Eric Palesteros, Judith Larson, Ian Marks, and Alex Potts. Entry number two. The Idolmaster, 765 production members, Hibiki, Makoto, Haruka, and Yukio, performing Change. Skit division. The world of Remnant has been plunged into an era of war. Huntsmen and huntresses everywhere have answered the call of battle, and though it has left many deep wounds, some scars will never heal. Joan Arc, Lay Rin, Neptune Basilius, Mercury Black, Fox Alistair, and Yatsuhashi Daichi from RWBY.
Thank you.
Valkyrie, Fox, and Daichi from RWBY, worn by Shatter. Created by Ivan Nguyen and Christian Campos. Entry number 5 in our open skit category. Aladdin really likes to make new friends, but when he tries to make new friends, things get a little bit weird. Especially when it's cold outside. Let's join Judar and Morgiana. Entry number 6 in our open skit division. Humans and faunas, please put your hands together for the Ice Queen, Ice Cream, and Queen of the Castle. Welcome Weiss, Neo, and Nora to the stage from RWBY, worn by the Sass Girls.
Longway, it's been just a wonderful day shopping with you and being away from the team. Some time away from them because they can get a little obnoxious after a while.
I have no idea why they would ever seem so annoying. Everyone seems great, especially Aang and all of her funny moments that go out with a bang. Man, can she take a hit. But the food fight we had was the best. I was definitely the queen of that castle. Even Ren lasted longer than you, Vicey.
Excuse me? How dare the nerve!
Oh, calm down, Ice Queen. Boop. Everyone knows the Beowulf Hunter's the best.
Excuse me? Care to remember that I killed a boar tusk and without me, Ruby would have never finished off that Nevermore on the first day of school. And you think you're better than me?
Yes, I do. After all, I flew in to save your team's butts. Plapow! If you think you're so much better than me, prove it, Snowflake.
I can do anything.
No, you can't. No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
Anything you can be, I can be.
And Jessica as Dio. Now, for our advanced division skits. Entry number one. Anyone who keeps up with the news knows that countries can never seem to agree on anything. Please welcome Inside the Costume Closet as they present a little international debate between Prussia and Hungary from Italia.
No, you can.
Yes, I can.
No, you can.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
Anything you can be, I can be greater. Sooner or later, I'm greater than you.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. I can shoot a partridge with a single cartridge.
I can get a sparrow with the bow and arrow.
I can live on bread and cheese.
And only on that?
You bet.
So good old rat.
Entry number two in our skit advanced division. Introducing for the first time on an American stage, an A-Kon first look, Samurai Titan Shadow, DJ Brona. Genderman from League of Legends and Neon Stripe 6. Worn by Samurai Titans, Yoshi Jackson. Created by Samurai Titans, LLC. Entry number 3. And I might add, our final entry. In our skit advanced division. Up and coming boxer, Little Mac has reached the pinnacle of his career. With his world championship title match only minutes away. He suddenly awakens to find himself withheld by a mysterious, omniscient force. Forever Alone is proud to present 30 Minutes.
All right, that's it. I demand an answer. Where am I?
Isn't it obvious? Your apartment.
No, this is clearly not my apartment. Listen, Buster, I have my championship title match in about 30 minutes, and if you don't show me the way out of this creepy place, I'm gonna punch some things.
Go right on ahead. The audience is watching.
Why is there an audience in my apartment? How did you even manage that?
They all look so weird.
There's a girl with bubblegum pink hair and donuts for her hair ornaments.
Don't fret the details. We only have 3 minutes in the skit to deliver a fully fleshed out story about this thrilling tale on your... Oh, can't say any more. That would be spoilers.
No, please, indulge me. You know what? No, forget about it. I'm taking things into my own hands. Omniscient voice or not, I'll just punch my way through. After all, I'm the soon-to-be champion of the world of boxing. Start punch! How's that? Now tell me how I can get out of this weird place or I'll hit you twice as hard.
You didn't land a single punch.
What? I totally did.
No, you were punching the air and making impact noises with your mouth.
Yeah, so?
It's because you're invisible and a coward.
Ugh, that doesn't matter. Can you please just let me get to my fight?
Hey, let's sing Take a Break from the action. This is totally not a distraction. Well, I'm not sure if I really want to. I don't know why I am feeling so.
Wait, no! You are not going to rope me into a musical segue!
Very well. Let us just reach the conclusion of the skit, since you're so eager.
I can't move. How are you doing this? You're gonna stop this right now. I seriously need to get to my fight and...
You still don't understand, do you?
Understand what? What are you saying? You've been making no sense.
The crowd is on the edge of their seats. The fight has been ended prematurely. It seems that the boxer has suffered a fatal blow to the head.
He isn't breathing. We need medical assistance immediately.
Hey, what kind of joke is this?
I can assure you, this is no joke.
The people in this audience, then? Who are they?
They are arbiters. People who will judge you based upon your actions.
Judge me? For what? Hey, where are you? Listen to me, please! And all of you! Don't just look at me! Do something, please!
Pronounced dead on arrival to the scene, the aspiring boxer took a great blow to the head during his match, thus ending his career and his life.
From Punch Out, worn by Forever Alone, created by Leo and Lonnie. Let's give it up for all our skits, events category, and general division.
Hey guys, thanks for being so patient. We're just gonna get it started, and we're gonna start with our judges' awards. And first, we will start with Carl.
Okay, so I really like this group quite a bit, and everyone, all their scenes were on point, and even on stage, they were on point. I picked the Mars, Venus, and Jupiter, number 41. Open 41.
Saw them from the back, like 10 feet away, and I was like, oh my god, that, I want that. And they appealed to my inner magical girl. So I'm giving my award to number 15, Advanced, the Ray Earth pair.
Love this game, and it's just like amazing, and it's Star Fox, because it's Star Fox!
A-Kon.
If you guys know anything about me, you know that I love everything that's cute. I don't know if it's obvious. So, my prize is cute even. I have my own special prize. I'm giving my judges award to Rosie from Animal Crossing, number 48.
Thank you.
and that is from the Advanced Walk-Ons, number 27, Dark Souls Orenstein.
Thank you.
know. Okay, second place in the open division is number 47 from Monster Hunter 4. Which is to tell you where all our wonderful prizes came from. So let me do that real fast. We received prize donations from Daisuke, Crunchyroll, Funimation, Sentai Filmworks, Aniplex, Ardo Wigs, and Stage Makeup Online. So they all donated wonderful stuff to give out as our prizes. So you get swag as well as trophies. Okay, moving right along. Second place in the advanced division, number 14, Vagrant Story. The best craftsmanship, the best detail work, like literally the best work that any of us saw, and unanimously we decided that best in show is the Alchemist Poison Ivy, number 17. on her outfit are handcrafted out of leather. She hand-textured every scale and applied them separately. She literally spent an entire year and a half on this costume. It was unbelievable. She should be working for a movie studio at this point, seriously. All right, that's all our awards. Thank you for coming to the A-Kon Cosplay Contest. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope y'all had fun. Please file out in an orderly fashion. Do not rush the doors.